Hey guys, it's Michael Todd, and welcome to The Cult of Vintage. Richard is back in the driver's seat. We are leaving Indianapolis, headed back to Urbana, Ohio, with, of course, the infamous lemon tree that was started as a pit 50 plus years ago by one of Richard's neighbor's mothers. It was living in a basement with a grow light. It's done pretty gosh darn well. So we're going to have to get a new pot. It's going to go at the atrium at the inn. Are you excited?
Yep.
So excited.
I'm driving.
He's driving. Safety first. So we're back on our way. Here we go. Hello. Okay, so we are in Cambridge City in, are we in Ohio? We are in Ohio. You think?
I think this is Indiana.
Oh, we're still in Indiana?
I think we're still in Indiana.
We're in Cambridge City, Indiana. There's a couple of antique malls. We've been here before. So we're going to maybe try to check out some places that we haven't been. Maybe there's a big one down here that, you know, we'll film. You never know. It's a new day. We didn't really make out all that well the last couple of times we were here. It's an antique mall city, so kind of the prices are a little bit up there, even though we're in the middle of nowhere, Indiana. So we'll see what we can find, get it on camera. We're going to share it with you guys, and let's do it. Okay. Look at that cute little house, though. Isn't that cute? But here's your little town. Down there is the big antique mall, but it's kind of like, again, in the middle of nowhere. Let's see. But a number of different antique malls. We're not going to go in this one just because we're not. We're going to start over here, which we got all kinds of antiques, primitives, bottles. We'll see if there's anything in there. Looks fun. Hey, I dig it. We've got primitives, right? Old salvage. Oh!
You don't need those 10 years.
Nah, we're going, you know, what's 10 years? What's 10 years? But we do have some mid-century over here, so it's really cool to see that. She's sashy. She's thinking about life. She's unsure of it all. Oh, she's filled with styrofoam. She doesn't have a price. Our lady in green here. Look at that wing eyeliner. Is it sold, though? Florist foam. No price. It's a great look to the store, though. Look at those giant barrels. There's a mantle over there. We got front grills to cars up there. Apple barrels, old cars, car doors, bikes. I like it. It's fun. Now that is a creepy baby. Oh, there's even ones in the closet. Raw. So it was a great aesthetic. We didn't see a whole lot of prices on things. Some of the stuff that we did see prices on were beyond the reseller budget. So we're going to go ahead and...
So diplomatic.
They were aggressive. So we're going to move on and see what we can find at a different place, guys. Here we go. Here's kind of what we're dealing with on this one. It is well done. It's warm. It smells good. A lot of... What would this be like? The primitive, early American shakery. Though again, it's pretty nice to see the building. That archway would be original, yeah. Do you think?
It looks pretty old.
So it does encompass quite a few. The floors are original. Now it does say that it has an antique or antiques are downstairs. That's a nice. Look at the color on that one. Wait your turn. So we'll try checking out downstairs and see what we can find. Richard pointed out that the archway is not original because you can see the original mortar and the newer mortar. The floors do differentiate. Both are old, but this would have been a separate.
Center is new.
This would have been a separate building, so maybe they.
There's a difference. Building.
Different building. And look at the gapping in those.
I mean, it is pretty cool, but we'll check out downstairs, see maybe if there's something more in line. Unusual tin ceiling. Obviously painted. Okay, here's hoping. Well, it's just kind of, honestly, more of the same. Oh, this isn't the same.
Gosh, this is, that's it for this half.
That's it. So there is another half that has it downstairs. So hopefully, exercise. Okay, so there is an upstairs. That's why I don't film and go upstairs. Oh, that's more very large furniture. These are narrow stairs. So check it out. It's very much a furniture gallery, which, you know, that's cool. So we'll try. Dude, that bed at the end's cool though.
The spindle?
This one?
Yeah, that's a Jenny Lynn.
Jenny Lynn!
Poster here.
Oh, this one? Ooh, yeah. Rope bed.
Yep. Nice early one.
Looks super comfy. Mm-hmm.
So that was just kind of...
It smells like marijuana. Did you get that on video?
Yeah, I did. It smells like marijuana out here.
That wasn't really our kind of store. Well, it could have been if maybe more of it was like a little more original. So there's some other places we're going to check out here, and we'll see you guys there. Here's the big one, National Road Antique Mall. We're gonna get inside, see if we can find anything in here, guys. Here we go.
Okay, so we have a little bit more of a traditional antique mall here. Of course, we've got some display cabinets set up. It did look like there was some open air booths here. So we'll check it out, see if we can find anything. Always love seeing Christmas represented year round. And old school Ronald McDonald, get it. And lots of jewelry. We have that. Some pretty glass here. 75. Now there's 15% off, but that's still a little spendy for us. Well, guys, I'm not really finding a whole lot in here. Again, we're seeing some of the more contemporary primitive stuff, which I think has a good aesthetic. It's, you know, it's not necessarily personally mine, but I'm looking for good vintage and antiques. We have 50% off of milk glass. They must have had a run on it is what happened. We have 20% off the entire booth. Okay, so over here, we've got some kitsch. I do see little Toodles, salt and pepper shaker, and what looks to be the napkin holder. Yeah, so how much do we have on Toodles? Isn't that the original Toodles? It's cute. Maybe it's on this. You have to buy all three pieces. $17.50 for all three. That's actually pretty gosh darn good with 20% off, so we'll go ahead and get that. We found some pretty blue glass, a three-footed with a little bit of opalescence. 14, was there a sale on it at all by chance?
I don't think so.
I think for 14 we can get that. And I found this set for $17.50, so we'll get all three of those. All four of those. All right, we do have some head vases over here. I'm curious as to where they're at. 42, 50, 30. Ooh, that one in the back. I see her hiding back there. You can barely spot her. That's a good one. She's super stylized too. I think she is Napco. She's at 55. She's in a Narco. Look at that. Oh. A little bit of her polka dots are missing, but that is an exceptional one. Right up here, I see a really unusual shape. See that? Oh, I don't know what to think about that. What do you think? It's different? Uh-huh. Is that the diplomatic response? 25. I don't know what to think of it. Old. It does look old. It's like a flower, wouldn't you think? Mm-hmm. I don't know. I'm probably gonna leave that one. I don't know, should I get it? Anarcho. Oh, I can look it up by the number. Let's do that. Well, you can actually pick one up right now on eBay for $42, so I'm not going to outdo that price, but I think that she is absolutely amazing. We're going to leave her right out here to the front. Maybe somebody else will see her and love her and snatch her up, but oh well. He's back there creeping. What'd you find? Blue bowl, $32.99. That's a little spendy. This little leaf measuring cup, it's missing its plastic right here. It's missing its acrylic little spoons. Oh, that is a tight fit, I will say that. All right. You can even get baby Yoda Chia Pet here. I mean, come on, folks. Here we've got a nice canary yellow chenille. They have it priced at $40. I always check out the price before I even bother to open it to see if it's worth it. I'm gonna check the pattern. It looks like it's more of a simple one. We'll see what we think here. I mean, yeah, it's in really good condition, but the pattern is just so simple. I don't think it's got a lot of high impact. So great condition, great price for a collector, maybe somebody that's working in the yellow color palette. But for me, I want it to be, oh, never mind, look. All of the chenille over here has been pulled out. You see it, how bald it is? Yes. So we're definitely gonna leave that one behind. In the sunlight, so yeah, that was about it. So we're gonna head on back, I think, to Urbana, and we'll get the tree unloaded and get that set up, and we'll let you guys check that out. So we'll see you here in just a little bit, for you guys at least. So welcome to Scioto Inn Atrium. Just figuring it all out. Right there's the tree. There's a fan. There's the light sources. That is the pot that it's currently in, but it will need to go into a larger one. You're contemplating what right now, sir? You're thinking about over there?
I have to rearrange to make everything fit. This planet's so big, it's gotta be tucked into a corner.
Okay.
Unless I trim it back. I hate to do that.
We'll be back.
Alrighty guys, here we are, the exterior of the inn, Scioto Inn. Thank you to everybody that has made a reservation for our Misty and I's antique excursion, of course, hosted by Richard. We're gonna check out what we see when we walk into the atrium. What do you think? I think that looks amazing. Do you not? There's the man, the owner. The proprietor, Mr. Colvin. And I think that looks great. Are you pleased? Mm-hmm. It really, I mean, it opened that space up.
Get a new pot and
reach the thing. She definitely needs a bigger pot. Mm-hmm. I'm voting for Lamona. Lamona is what we should call her. Lamona. Uh-huh. But I think it looks wonderful. There's the interior, just in case. Okay. One more quick shot. I think it looks beautiful.
Well done. Alrighty, guys. Well, there you have it. I'm pointing to the lens to make sure we're looking at it. Thank you for... Yes, yeah, see. Thank you for joining along with this adventure with us this week. Lamona's back there living her best new life. I hope you guys have enjoyed this series of videos. Stay tuned for more. So that is it, guys. And until next time, remember, keep it rusty, crusty, and dusty. Bye, guys.
Bye.